Today's the feast of Corpus Christi, and all of you know the translations, the body of Christ, right? The body of Christ. And that's who we receive every Sunday, right? That's who it is that we receive. Often we hear people today, is it a waste of time going to church? If you look at statistics, probably about two-thirds of Catholics today say it is. And that's even, it could be even probably greater than two-thirds, sadly, isn't it? At least two-thirds of Catholics say it's a waste of time. A churchgoer wrote a letter to a paper saying that exact same thing. He said, you know, it makes no sense to go to church every Sunday. He said, I've heard over 3,000 homilies in the 30 years that I've been going to church. He said, but for the life of me, I can't remember one of them. It's probably the same with you too, isn't it? So I think I'm wasting my time, and the pastor's wasting his time by giving any sermon at all. The editor of the newspaper responded, I've been married for 30 years. He said that in that time, my wife has cooked for me some 32,000 meals. But for the life of me, I can't recall the entire menu for a single one of those meals. But I know this. They all nourished me and gave me the strength I needed to do my work. If my wife had not given me those meals, I would be physically dead. Likewise, if I had not gone to church for nourishment, I would be spiritually dead. Interesting statement, isn't it, my friends? When we receive him, we receive something, don't we? Because we receive someone. Often another question people say, what do I get out of this? It doesn't look like much going on. Prayers that are recited verbatim, we don't really even know. Half the time we just respond. I know that my prayers, you know yours, you say yours, I say mine. We stand, sit, and it goes back and forth, right? You say your section, I say mine. Up, down, up, down. What do we get out of this? What do we get out of this? A farmer had a very large rock in the corner of his property. And because of the location of the rock, it kind of dipped off. He couldn't remove it with his tractor, and it was raising havoc with his farm equipment. One day he had a dream. Jesus appeared to him and said, you know, you need to push against that rock with all your strength every day. Do not let a day pass by where you don't push against that rock. And push against it with all your strength. With all your strength. So at the beginning of the day, always, and at the end of the day, before he went back to his home, he would always spend time pushing against that rock, hoping to push it off the ledge there and into the embankment. This went on for years. Every now and then he'd hear a voice in his head saying, you've been pushing against this rock for a long time and it hasn't budged. You're wasting your time. You're never going to move it. But he continued to push. He continued to push. After 20 years, one night after a very long day, he cried out in prayer, Lord, I've labored day and night pushing against that rock with all my strength. I've done what you asked, but after all this time, I haven't budged that rock one inch. What is wrong? Why am I wasting my time pushing against that rock? During that prayer and that cry of anguish, he heard a voice in his heart say to him, I've asked you to push against that rock, and you have faithfully done so for 20 years. Never once did I say to you that I expected you to move it. Now you come to me thinking you have failed. Look at yourself. Look at your arms and your back, how strong, how resilient, and how muscled they are. Your hands are calloused, but look how much work they're capable of doing. Your legs have become massive and hard. By pushing against that rock, you have gained so much and you have surpassed what you used to be. You haven't moved that rock, how true. But you were faithful. And look at the person you've become. Now, my friend, he said, I will move that rock. Look at the person you've become. That's who we come to church, don't we, my friends? If we come and push against that rock, make an effort, and push again the next week, and 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 again the next week, look at the person you will become. You will become who you receive. And if you come and don't push, guess what? Guess what? You remain who you are. You remain who you are. He wants and expects us to push against that rock because he wants us to become like him. Like him it is who we receive every Sunday. God bless you. Let us now stand and profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible.